The next 2 months will be a stock picker's game with stock selection as the key focus. I want to emphasize that during this period, the primary driver of profitability will be selecting the right stocks and groups. Unlike the past 2 years when market timing played a more critical role than stock selection, we now strongly believe that stock selection will take precedence. For the last 2 years, we've been telling you pretty much to buy on the pullbacks. And it was a pretty easy game the last 2 years. We're starting to see a change where stock selection is becoming a lot more important. In this video, I will expand on indicators I use to incorporate a fundamental commandment of stock selection for my system. With this approach, I focus on buying stocks that are trending higher and trading above their moving averages, while shorting stocks that are in a downtrend and trading below their moving averages. For me, it's technical analysis 101. Buy stocks that are uptrending, short stocks that are downtrending. While this statement, stock selection, is somewhat self-evident and generally true to some degree, there are specific markets where it becomes especially relevant. For instance, in 1977, while the blue chip averages experienced a baby bear market, many secondary stocks completely ignored the decline and continue to move upward. We believe the current market climate is shaping up to be another such scenario. Hello, investors and traders. Over the last 3 years, we have achieved 3 consistent years of consistency and developed a winning system. I am not here to sell you anything. I am here to challenge you to build your own system and to have great returns based on your risk level. We are not only for the swing traders, but we are also for the long-term investors. Let me be upfront. I am not a perfect trader or investor. However, I have maintained a high level of accuracy over the past 3 years, which we have documented on YouTube. The overarching blueprint we've been following for the last 2 years has been to buy on the pullbacks, specifically the Magnificent Seven. Right now, we're in the 9th inning of a baseball game or the 4th quarter of a football game. I believe this year will still close on an upward note as a lot of uncertainties about political, economical, and geopolitical issues start to clear up. The markets is likely to move even higher, but there is a caveat, as I have seen smart money pulling out of the stock market, even though the averages seem higher. This will be a very selective advance. At some point next year, we may transition into a bear market with commodities rising even as interest rates begin to decline. For now, let's enjoy the momentum and stay focused on buying during pullbacks, but this time a lot more selective. 2 years ago, we backed up the truck. It was the time to be extremely bullish. Now, it's a time to be a sniper. Now it's the time. Yes, the market we believe will go up the next month, maybe into a little bit into January. But it's not to back up the truck. It's to start raising up cash when we have our pullback in the next 1 to 2 years. You will have the opportunity to buy at better prices. 3 years ago when we told you to short into the market and buy into commodities, nobody believed it. 2 years ago when we told you to buy into this market and back up the truck on all pullbacks, it seemed impossible. Now, even though this market is at highs and it could stay at highs for months, that's why we say selective buying and selective shorting is the best way. I'm going to call this market the tale of two tapes. The key is to identify uptrending stocks and go long on them while finding downtrending stocks and shorting them. An uptrend is defined as a series of higher peaks and higher lows in a given stock or market average, lasting anywhere from several weeks to years. Conversely, a downtrend is characterized by a series of lower peaks and lower bottoms following the same time frame. I specifically focus on the 30-day, 50-day, and 200-day moving averages. These act as a foundation for evaluating the security or stock you are trading. If you are going long, the stock should be trading above these moving averages. If you are shorting, the stock should be trading below them. A picture is worth 1,000 words. And this does not work out all the time, but we are feeling the 4-year presidential cycle has worked out very well for us the first 3 years on YouTube, and we see it the same way happening. As we see going up to the election year, the market rises. And then the next year following, the market will have a pullback. I do not think this will be a full blast economic crisis like a Lehman Brothers, like a Great Depression. But I do feel there will be pullbacks, followed by the third year, where we'll have greater opportunities to get in. And then the year before the elections, it will go up. This is really chess move thinking. And we're trying to think 3 to 4 years ahead and plan everything out. Thus saying that, I still think we can make money on the long side with being selective buyers for at least the next 1.5 months. This is the plan of what I think will happen, but sometimes plans change. But to have an overall picture of where we're going for the next 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, and what our plan is, it's a pretty powerful move not to think day to day or let your emotions take over you because of any political party running in. I always tell you, this channel is not about politics. I am not here to tell you to vote for Trump or Kamala's no good or the Democrats are bad or the Republicans are bad. I am here to try to walk you through my system and how am I going to make money. Clearly, Trump benefits certain industries. Clearly, Kamala Democrats benefit certain industries. So no matter where you are politically, it doesn't matter. It matters to what we have in front of us. And if Kamala would have won, certain sectors would go up. But that did not happen. President Trump will be the next president, and we need to follow a 4-year presidential cycle and also understand what he benefits and historically and technically how we're going to benefit and make money in this market. Leave your politics to the side. How do I like to look at it on a long-term plan? The markets go through 4 different phases. There's the accumulation phase, the growth phase, the distribution phase, and the decline phase. Now, the growth phase and the declining phase may vary in the percentages. They are up or down respectively, but still, you could say you can break the stock market down into these 4 different phases. Clearly, 22, the end was the accumulation phase, and 23 and 24 was the growth phase. Now I feel we are in this what's called a distribution phase, and this could last 6 months. We could even break to a little bit of new highs, but we will have a pullback, and this is what I'm waiting for, the pullback. So this is our long-term plan, is to wait till nobody else wants stocks, to wait till we have an economic pullback, which statistically we have in years 3 and 4 of an election cycle. Before we get started, disclaimer, the information provided on our channel is for educational informational purposes only and is not intended to be a substitute for professional financial advice. I am not your financial advisor. I encourage you to build a system. I encourage you to take certain indicators, put it together to have a probability of succeeding. This is what I do for myself because I am not selling you anything. I am a top-down trader that looks at the big picture. I'm trying to find a trading edge to predict the overall market. I have a probability of succeeding, and I am consistent in my approach. This is a rule-based system. What I am doing is I am combining many indicators to give me a weight of evidence to help me with my 3-part process: overall market, sector phases, and individual securities. My official recommendation right now is short-term neutral, intermediate-term bullish, and long-term neutral. If you remember in 2023, on January 18th, we put in our official buy recommendation off our long-term QQQs. And for about 2 years, every month, every week, we kept telling you to buy on the pullbacks. On October 28th, we took 80% of our long-term positions off the table, even though we thought November, December was going to be good months in the stock market. When you have just off the QQQs a 74% gain and not what we did off of all the Magnificent Seven, the options, and all the other plays that we did the last 2 years, taking profit is not a bad move. If we had left it in there, the 80% of our position, we would have made a half a percent. And if you look at back at our picture here of what we know is coming, growth phase to distribution phase to declining phase, taking a few chips off the table is not a bad play. It's going to go against a lot of what you're thinking, a lot of what your emotion is thinking. Thus saying that, we will become stock pickers. And the next few videos will be all about individual securities and stock picking. But before that, you need to know the overall market. If you look at the stage analysis, it is for the S&P 500 securities, 61% bullish, 39% bearish, 54% bullish, 46% bearish. Leaning towards the bullish, which makes sense for December and the announcement of Donald Trump as president, but not signs of the next bull market. Not an accumulation phase into a growth phase. An overbought market, which could last 6 months, a year, or 2 years, still overbought and go up higher, but we are coming close to the end. The Nasdaq is more evenly with 54% and 46%, but still a bullish reading. We go to the fear factor. And if you see the fear factor first on a 50-day moving average, it's kind of neutral. It's been hovering around these areas for a long time. But if you look at the contract itself, again, it's not a screaming buy at these levels here. Now, what I have also learned is something that should be happening in January, February, March may not happen. We're just preparing ourselves for the inevitable pullback that will happen sooner or later. And the VIX is giving us a bearish signal right now because there's not much fear in the market. If you go to our short-term indicator, where 100 is overbought and zero is oversold for the short term, we're kind of neutral in this reading also. If you go to the CCI indicator, which we just recently come out with a video about, the whole system itself, some are bullish, some are bearish, but no clear indication. Now, if you go for the swing traders out there, our overbought, oversold neutral indicator is again very neutral. If you go to the components of the overbought, oversold, we are in a neutral position. This is why I'm saying that this is not the best time to go super long this market. And this is not the best time really to go super short this market. But moves need to be made. And these moves will revolve around uptrending stocks and downtrending stocks. As we continue further to individual securities, the Magnificent Seven looks pretty positive in a bullish, where the majority are in an uptrend. If you look at the market sentiment, we are bearish. If you look at the put call options, we are at extreme greed. Again, one indicator does not make a whole system, but this is definitely a warning sign when many individual investors are buying call options and betting this market will go up higher, while many hedge funds are taking their money off the table. If we look at the RIDEX ratio, again, another bearish sign for us. And then you go to the stock price strength, which looks at 52-week highs, and it's bearish. Again, another sign is that a lot of the indexes are hitting new highs, yet a lot of 52-week new highs are not there, which again is saying it's a very selective market. So what is next in this market? Well, for the long-term investors, and you, if you've been in this market for the last 2 years, you satisfied the capital tax advantage. So taking some profits off the table is not a bad idea. For the swing traders, the next video that comes out will be individual stocks to go long and to go short for a swing trade. What we're trying to do today here is to get a high probability of what is going to happen next. And if you combine these factors together, the game plan that we have is that sometime next year, you will have a pullback. In that time of the pullback, we are going to try to do swing trading, picking individual securities to go long and individual securities to go short. We think sooner or later it will become a full-blown pullback and with a lot of money switching to commodities, but we're not there yet. So you know the catchphrase, study it, analyze it, adapt it, peace.